We're back in Building 7 again in the spacesuit lab with Marc Ciupitu again, and he's going to tell us, we talked a little bit last time about the Orlon suit, and he's going to tell us a little bit now about how it differs from the EMU, the extra-vehicular mobility unit that we use on U.S. spacewalks. So we've got the EMU here next to us. Maybe you can point out a few of the features.
Sure. I mentioned that on the Orlon, how you ingress through a door in the back of the suit. So that's one of the main differences between the two suits, how you put the suit on, how you don it. The EMU is made more like clothing, basically. You have all these components that you have to put on. The hard upper torso is attached in the station so the crew can ingress it. But for each crew member, you have to add their own arms, their own lower torso. So the crew ingresses through the hard upper torso, and then they have to pull the pants, if you will, the lower torso assembly on, and then lock that into place. They have to put the helmet on as well, because that's not attached like on the Orlon. And then lastly, they put on the gloves.
Okay, so, and you were showing us on the Orlon suit how they have to kind of cinch to the different sizes. We have different size arms and legs and hard upper body torsos.
Correct.
Things like that, right?
Each crew member, the EMU is tailored to them specifically, so we launch specific components for them to match their sizing.
So you can have really long arms but really short legs if you want.
That's right.
Okay. And then we've seen people get into the suits on the station in microgravity. I'm sure it's probably even a little easier than it is here, but you have to kind of crawl up into it.
Correct. The backpack, the pliss, is locked in place in the station. The crew will have already donned the lower torso, and then they have to sort of wheel their way inside the hard upper torso through the arms. Mm-hmm. And it's not an easy procedure. And once they're in there, they lock the lower torso in place, and then the helmet.
Okay. And how long does it take us to get ready for a spacewalk?
We're about around 4 hours, around the same time.
Okay.
The other difference to point out is you see the display and control module here. It basically has all the components put together that you see on the Orlon. Is split up in four. You have this control, electrical control panel, the gauge, the pneumo-hydraulic, and the interface for the umbilical. It's four separate areas, whereas on the EMU, it's all together on the display and control module.
And I always think it's interesting how the letters and numbers are backwards on the suit.
Correct. It's the crew member can only see using wrist mirrors that they put on the gloves, so they have to put everything
they're
in
like
the image. Right.
Here.
They've installed on the
Yeah,
and gloves.
Then they can hold it in front of their chest to see.
That's the only way they can see, basically,
okay.
On their chest. And another main difference to point out is the pressure inside each suit. The EMU operates at 4.3 PSI.
Mm-hmm.
The Orlon we're up is a little bit higher at 5.8 PSI.
Mm-hmm.
So the EMU is a little less strenuous for the crew members to work in,
okay.
More flexible.
All right. And our suit was designed when we were starting the shuttle program, right? And I'm sure, I don't know, how old is the Orlon?
The Orlon has first version back in the Voskhod and when they had the Salyut, mm-hmm. their space station. So it's been in from the late 60s.
So yeah, we're doing really pretty amazing things with some old technology.
That's correct. We worked on trying to achieve the same goal independently, continents apart, but we came to the same goal, just different avenues.
Mm-hmm.
But in the end, they're all doing the same thing.
Yeah. And I know here at NASA, we're working on building some new designs for spacesuits, and we should get some cool stuff to see pretty soon.
And hopefully we can collaborate with our international partners, and we'll come up with a good final product. So.
Absolutely. Well, thank you again, Marc. We really appreciate you talking with us.
Well, thank you very much.